Raja Madhurya Prem. And he appeared before Lord Chaitanya, just as when Brahma went with the Devas and the earth personified to the shore of the milk ocean, then Krishna, or Srila Lakshmi Vishnu, indicated that Krishna would appear, but before that, his associates would appear to make way for his lila. So similarly with Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, some associates appeared before him in order to prepare for his lila. And part of his lila was to taste the confidential moons of Srimati Radhika, and part was also to distribute Raja Prem, and particularly Gopi Manjari Prem. So Madhavendra Puri was sent in advance, and he carried this mood. And then this mood was bestowed upon his disciple Ishwara Puri, and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in his lila accepted Diksha from Ishwara Puri and thus inherited this same mood. Of course, it is coming from him because he is the root of it. So Madhavendra Puri was always absorbed in this state, as Srila Gurudev was saying. He was absorbed in the state of feeling himself as a Manjari maid servant of Srimati Radhika. And in this way he was wandering here and there. He had a vow that he would never beg alms from anyone. So sometimes he would go for several days without eating. And only if someone approached him and offered him something, then he would accept. Otherwise, he would never request anyone. So one time, he was wandering in Vrindavan, in this state of ecstasy, always remembering Krishna. And also, he always stayed alone, because he did not want to come into an association of others and then have to engage in mundane talks. So he would walk absorbed in chanting and remembering Krishna's lila and forgetting whether it was day or whether it was night or where he was going. So he was wandering in this state in Braj and hadn't eaten for perhaps 2 or 3 days. And then a beautiful young boy came to him. And he brought a pot of milk in a clay pot, and the boy was very immediately attracted his mind. So Madhavendra Puri was astonished because he is not attracted to anything in this world, always absorbed internally in meditating on Krishna. But when he saw this boy completely captivated his mind, and he was wondering, why am I so attracted to this boy? So the boy, he brought this pot of milk and he said, "My dear sannyasi, I see that you have been fasting, so I brought this pot of milk for you." So he said, "How did you know I was fasting?" And the boy replied, "Well, the village women, they have noticed you wandering here and there and not taking anything. And in our village, we don't allow anyone to go hungry. So they have given me this pot of milk and they have requested me to give it to you." So Madhavendra Puri accepted and he drank the milk. And then at the next moment, the boy had disappeared and he was not able to find him anywhere. So then he went on chanting and chanting through the night. And then at a certain point, he dozed off. Of course, even in sleeping, he's not actually sleeping like us, but always meditating on Krishna and remembering Krishna's lila.
After the boy went, mm-hmm. they took to milk.
Yeah.
And then he left it.
So, in the dream, or in his dreams, the same boy came to him again. And then he understood that this boy was Krishna. And in the dream, Krishna said that, "I have been waiting for you for a long time." Because at that time, the Muslims, they were ruling India. And the Muslims they attacked many of the temples and destroyed many of the deities. So the pujaris, they would sometimes, if they got warning that the Muslims were coming, then they would take the deity and they would hide it somewhere in order to protect it. So this pujari, he had hidden the deity of Gopal in a dense forest and then had fled for his life. So this boy Krishna, he came to Madhavendra Puri in his dream and he said that, I've been waiting a long time for you. I'm hidden in the jungle and you please rescue me. So when Madhavendra Puri awoke from the dream, then he was actually condemning himself that, oh, this boy came to me. Krishna actually came to me directly and I could not recognize him. So then he gathered some of the townspeople, or the village people rather, and they took knives and machetes and whatnot, and the forest was very dense, so many weeds and branches. So they cut through the vegetation and then they found the deity of Gopal. And then Madhavendra Puri for several days performed a installation ceremony for Gopal. So on top of Giriraj Govardhan, on some slab of stone there, they placed the deity, and many Brahmins were called there in order to perform the jagya and the puja. And also, Madhavendra Puri called for foodstuffs to be brought from all the neighboring villages. And so a great quantity of foodstuffs were prepared. And then they were also performing abhishek, bathing the deity, like we did yesterday. So this was going on for several days. But the deity of Gopal had been, for a very long time, had been buried in the earth. And of course, India is very hot, especially in the summertime. So Gopal again appeared to Madhavendra Puri in a dream. And he said that in spite of this abhishek, this bathing going on for several days, still my body is very hot. So you please go to Jagannath Puri and you get sandalwood paste. There's Malayan chandan there, the very famous sandalwood. So this is a very long way from Vrindavan, and at that time there was no planes or trains or anything like that. So Madhavendra Puri, he went everywhere on foot. So it was a very long journey and there were many obstacles to face because the Muslims were ruling at the time, and there were so many different like border crossings and whatnot. So Madhavendra Puri took up this journey, and when he got to Remuna, which is not so far from Puri, there's one deity of Gopinath there. And this deity is a very famous deity, and they used to offer kheer to this deity. And this kheer was renowned all over. So Madhavendra Puri, he was thinking that if we can offer this type of kheer to Gopal, it will be very nice. So when he was thinking like that, it was as if he was desiring to sample the kheer in order to be able to prepare it in the same way. But at the same moment, he chastised himself because he considered that, oh, I am desiring to taste the kheer of Gopinath before it is even offered to him. So this is very sinful. So now I will have to fast. And he gave up his idea to taste the kheer. And he just simply went in the village and was chanting. But at night, Gopinath appeared in a dream to the pujari and said that, I have hidden a pot of kheer. They offer kheer to the deity. And he said, you did not notice, but I have hidden one pot underneath my cloth. So you should go and find it there. And then after that, you should find this sannyasi, this devotee, Maravendra Puri, and you should give it to him. So the pujari got up, washed himself, put on fresh cloth, and then went on the altar, and indeed, underneath the cloth of Gopinath was a pot of this sweet rice. So thereafter, this Gopinath became known as Kirchora Gopinath. Gopinath who stole, or the thief Gopinath, who stole sweet rice for his devotee, Maravendra Puri. So the pujari went out afterwards and he was calling all over. And finally he found Maravendra Puri. And then he gave him this sweet rice and he said that Gopinath has stolen this for you. You are so fortunate, you are so beloved to the Lord. So Maravendra Puri was appreciating the mercy of the Lord, the mercy of his dear Lord. Yet at the same time he was thinking that by the morning time this story will be spread all over. And then so much praise will come because people will be saying, oh, what a great devotee this person must be that Gopinath has stolen here for him. So he left that place immediately, not wanting to be praised. And he carried on with his journey. And then finally he arrived in Puri and he got the chandan and also some camphor to mix with it. And it was very heavy. So he got two other persons to help in carrying this. Yet still they were having to do this whole journey on foot and carry it on their backs. Something like 80 kilos, I think. So, as he was making his way back to Vrindavan, then Gopal again appeared to him in a dream for the third time. And he said that if you simply go to Ramuna again, to Gopinath, I am not different from Gopinath, or Gopinath is not different from I. So if you go there and you prepare this sandalwood for Gopinath, then I will be completely satisfied. It will be the same as if you apply it on me. So Maravendra Puri did this. He returned to Ramuna. And of course there he could not escape the fame which was coming to him, being such a great devotee of the Lord. But the Lord also did this to show the glory of Maravendra Puri and also to relieve him from having to return all the way to Braj with the chandan, and also to show that he is none different. All his forms are identical to him. So I'll stop there.
Madhavendra Puri was disciple of erring sannyasi of Madhvacharya Sampradaya. Lakshmi Pati Tirtha. Nityananda Prabhu was also disciple of the same Lakshmi Pati Tirtha. As Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was initiated by Ishwar Puri Maharaj. And he took sannyas from Keshav Bharati in Kantak Nagar. In the same way, Madhavendra Puri was originally disciple of Lakshmi Pati Tirtha. And after that, when Lakshmi Pati Tirtha passed away from this world, he wanted to take renounce order. But his Buddha was not there. So he took sannyas from anyone of Madhvacharya line and his name was Sampuri. Vishnupuri. And he became sannyasi. Understand? So he was Madhavendra Puri. If anyone can have an argument, a doubt that if he was in Madhvacharya Sampradaya, they are all called Tirtha. But how he can, he became Puri? Oh, also in Madhvacharya's line, some Tirth and some Puri also. So he took initiation first from Lakshmi Tirth, and after he passed away, he took renounce order from Vishnu Puri. He was also a very learned person and very high class, from whom he took initiation Lakshmi Pati Tirtha. They were in line of Madhvacharya and they were devotees of Bal Gopal. Bal Gopal, you know? Yes. And also in the same time, they would use to worship Narayan as that, Lakshmi Narayan. Actually they were worshipper of Lakshmi Narayan, but they used to worship Bal Gopal. They are all established tools are like that, Narayan. But this Puri, in the same line, he was in the line of Gopi's mood, Vishnu Puri. And he has written some books, very good books, about this, in the line of Gopi Prem. So he was not Tattvavadi, who? Madhvendra Puri. But he was at the Gopi mood, devotee, pure devotee. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu took initiation, one of the disciples of Madhvendra Puripada, that is he was Ishwar Puripada. In his last career, we see that he was always weeping with him. Oh Krishna, very loved, very loved. Always. Observing this, always weeping, crying bitterly so much. He Deva, He Daita, He Bhuvanaika Bandho, He Krishna, He Chapala, He Karunaika Sindho, He Nath, He Ramana, He Nayana Abhiram, Ha Ha Padam Bhavita Aspadam. Like Srimati Radhika, these two strokes of Radhika. But in the middle time, there was none who can recite these slokas. And in the same mood like Radhika, after long time, Madhvendra Puri became like this, like Braja Prem and Gopi Prem. He Deva means you are worshipable. You are so beautiful. I cannot forget you. Though you can forget us, and you have gone to Mathura, and you have so many beloveds there. We are Valini only one. Valini, you know, Gopi. We are not so much beautiful as Mathura, device of Yadavas. We are not so much beautiful. We have no so much quality like them. But we cannot live without you. We will die about you. So He Dev, He Dait. Dait means beloved. You are my beloved. But why you left us and went? Why? If you are calling us to Vrindavan, I cannot go there. We cannot go there. Why? Oh, you have so many beloved there. What is the use of our going in Mathura? There your father, mother and all are there. and he was so happy with them, we don't want to disturb him. But he was our guy, Daita. Daita, so much bigger him. He Deva, he Daita, he Bhuva Deva. Then, oh, I told wrong. You are Mathurana. Hey Mathurana. Oh, now you are the emperor of Mathura kingdom. You have left Vrindavan. Because you used to go to cowherds without umbrella, without any shoe, nothing. Without appearance wear. But now you have become Mathurana. So how you will remember us? Very simple gopis, not qualified at all. We cannot make garland like the women of Mathura, the Kishoris of Mathura. They can do so. They can serve you well, Mathurana. When you will return? When you will return? And sometimes thinking that, oh, Krishna has come. And making like this. Understand?
Come here.
Oh, who are you? Who are you? Lalita, Visakha, Chitra. No. And that one, oh, you Krishna? So who, when you come like this? Kada Balukasi. Hridayam Mukhi. You can imagine. He Nath, He Raman, He Nainath, Hiram, Ha Ha, Padan, Ha Ha,
He Devan, He Krishna, He Chakala, He Krishna, Ha Nath, He Ramana, He Ramanayana, He Ram.
So, beautiful meaning of this is love. And always remembering and always waiting. Once, His one disciple came there. You know that Ishwar Puri Pavan, serving all day with same mood as he was. Always serving in all ways, giving Mahaprasadam, making him bath, serving him in all respects. But another sister was also beside him, Ramchandra Puri. He came there and he told to him, then why are you with you jealously? Every dance order sannyasi shouldn't be. He should think that I am Brahma. I am Nirvishesh Brahma. No love and affection for anyone, even for his body. Nothing. He should be renounced. So why you are going to be? That happens, Madhvendra Puripa told his old disciples, take him and get him out of my assembly, Bhajan Kuti. I don't want to see his face again in my life. And he was driven out. And he gave his all moods to Ishwar Puripa. We have heard that how he was renounced, that he never begged anything to anyone. He knew that Krishna will arrange everything. Then Krishna took some milk in a pot and went to Govardhan, where Madhvendra Puri was always observed weeping, rolling down on the earth. And he gave, oh, my mother has seen you. You have not taken anything for 4 or 5 days and you are hungry. But you don't beg to anyone. So my mother has sent me to give this milk to you. You should take it and I am going to... And again I will come and I will take return this pot. Mahendra Puri. Was hearing, but giving no importance. But his sweet words and extending God in threefold aspect. And said, who is this boy? In my whole life, anyone, any boy, any girl, any wife, any woman, any person I have not saw in whole world, in my whole life. But how he challenged me? In what a position, in a mood he is standing threefold. How beautiful, though he is black, how beautiful. And how sweet words, I have never heard any sweet word like this. And he was doing like this. His eyelids were nut, always. And that boy turned in at once. Oh, he may know me so quickly. Oh, my mother will baby me, so I am just going on to return. And he did in such a mood that Madhavendrapuri took him in his heart. After that boy went and he was watching, chanting, but now no interest in chanting, only looking at who was that boy, who was that boy, who was that guy, what did he do? He went, the boy went, and he was watching the way, path. It so much time went, but he was always remembering that. Who was he? He was. In the meantime, he sleepiness, semblance of sleep came, but not so deep.
Dozing.
And he saw in it a very beautiful sand boy. And what he is narrated. From this Madhavendrapuri, Ishwarpuri path came. Not only Ishwarpuri path, the roots of bhakti. Madhavendrapuri is the whole tree. And not whole tree.
Roots.
And three, nine roots were Paramanandapuri, Ishwarpuri, Brahmananda, and so many.
Nine.
Advaita Acharya also, first disciple of same Madhavendrapuri. Also, Bhakrishna Pandit, what? The guru of Gadadhar Pandit. Pundarik Vidyanidhi. All were in this line. Not only Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Not luckily Chaitanya Mahaprabhu went to Ishwarpuri path. All knowingly they went in this line. So this line is genuine. Now some are doubting. They are the messenger of Kali. A spy of Kali. You should not trust him. So we should like to be a devotee like Madhavendra. Today is also this apparent day of who was he? Srinivas Acharya. He was disciple of Gopal Bhatta. He was in a very extricated Brahmin family. And for bringing childhood, he was so learned person in Sanskrit and Bengal. Hence. And he was so honest and good character person. He first went to see Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Nityananda Prabhu, Advaita Acharya, Gadadhar Pandit, in Navadvip. And then he started from his village, native place. When he came nearer to Navadvip, he heard that Mahaprabhu has left this world. And all his Advaita Acharya, every has left.
Then he became so upset.
He started to go for
Jagannathpuri.
I will meet Gadadhar Pandit. I will meet Sarup Namodar, Raghunath Das and all others. Shikhi Maiti, Madhuri Devi, Maharaj Pratap Rudra, Sarvam Bhattacharya. Very eagerly he was going. But when he was in the way, he heard that Gadadhar Prabhu has disappeared in the unke shok mein Mahaprabhu. Of separation of Mahaprabhu. Gadadhar Pandit. And he has entered in the deity of Gopinath. Tota Gopinath. He heard that Sarup Damodar has helped you. He heard that Raghunath Das Goswami has gone to from Jagannath Puri to Vrindavan only to die. He will go there and he will jump in Yamuna or he will go to Govardhan and from there jump. And thus he will die. But he could not. Rukshnathan said to him and he began to lead him Radhapur and doing so much high class of bhajan there, you know. Rupa Raghunath Pade Rahu Murad Prarthanaya Kare Sada. Rupa Raghunath Nare. Krishna Das. Same. Srivasa Acharya Prabhu. After that, he returned and he came to Vrindavan. And he was so much upset what to do. Mahaprabhu and all his followers happened. And he made when he came to Prayag, he heard that Rupa and Sanatana both had left this world. Now he was weeping so much loudly. Anyhow, he went to Vrindavan and he met with Jiva Goswami. And Jiva Goswami kindly kept him with him and began to give his association and all teaching all shastra to him. In the meantime, Narottam Thakur and Shyamananda also went to Vrindavan and all went to the school of Jiva Goswami. After that, when they were so much matured in all kinds of shastra, Jiva Goswami told that, I want to give you all the books of Rupa and Sanatana and of myself and all other books. And you should take it in a block card and go to Bengal and preach all over Bengal. Because now Bengal has become devotee-less. You should preach there very strongly. So, all the books of Jiva Goswami, Rupa Goswami, Ujjalinmani, Bhakti Goswami, Sindhu and all books compiled by Jiva Goswami, of Chaitanya Chaitanya, all the books were given in the court. And two, three protectors, guards, were going, and three boys, Narottam Thakur, Shyamananda, and Srinivas was more elder than both. And they used to serve him and to obey Srinivas Acharya. In the meantime, when the court was nearer to Bengal, in a very dense forest, some dravids came and their astrologer, that they have a very precious jewels in the court. And then the king of the dravids, Hamdi, was a very dangerous dravid. He at once followed with his followers. And anytime when they were sleeping, anyhow, taking rest, because they are all tired, in the meantime, quickly they took away, stolen the card. And when they went there and saw that what is there, only books. Oh, these are papers, not of any use. bogus thing. Third decade he called there. In the meantime, when they awoke and they saw that, oh, where is God? And they were doing like this, for
eating the head
and waiting so much. Shane was told that he should return to Bengal and I am here searching and after taking books I will return. Otherwise no. So Shyamananda Prabhu and Narottam Thakur went there and they gave some letter to Jiva Goswami and others that books have been stolen. But in the meantime, Srinivas was searching here and there like a beggar boy. One day he went in the council of king, that is Dhirambi, the commander-chief of all the doctors. And he saw that in his council some priest, Brahmin, was reading Srimad Bhagavata and explaining. It seems that this king is very religious and pious and he has some bhakti with Krishna. So I should anyhow mix with this and I should please him and then I will search. When the Harikatha explaining of Bhagavata was finished, Srinivas as a boy of only 18 years, and he stood up and told to king, "O king, I want to explain the same slokas which he has explained. I think he has not explained well." And then he began to explain. King told that, "I want to hear your explanations." And all were so loved it. So he began to. But Madhupakitava Bandho Maspri Sangri Shapatna Bis. I am explained in such a way the separation mode of Radhika and Gopis and Krishna. Himself he was weeping so bitterly. And all the counselors began to weep. And he explained 3-4 hours. And quickly time passed. After 3-4 hours, when he finished one shloka, and then king himself with his all counselors went in and fell flat on the lotus feet of Srinivasa. Oh, how beautiful it is. We want that you should initiate us. We are all searching of a very pure, bona fide, qualified guru. I see that in the whole world. I cannot have a guru like you. You are bona fide. I have never seen a person like you, so qualified. He told that, "I can, but you will have to give some dakshina to me, otherwise not. If you are taking harinam or vichar and initiation and not giving something, donation, not donation but dakshina to Gurudev, that diksha will not be successful. Initiation will, Guru will not never want anything. But we should do. Shorten. If you are brahmachari, you cannot give, then you should give yourself, your body, mind, soul, everything. And if you grihastha, you should give anything. What is so precious and which will be useful for my Gurudev? This should be. So, he told, the king answered that, "I know this thing. I will give you anything you like." Then he told, I have lost a full of books and very useful wealth, like more than jewels valuable. So if you can give me this donation, then I can. King began to smile. "Oh, how did you that these books are with me and how can I help?" And he again fell flat on the lotus feet. "Just now I am giving you before initiation. And after initiation, I build myself, my kingdom, my whole family, everything forever. And then, at once he ordered that, that bull of horse with me. Brought here with, as it was, full of books. Oh, then books were. Srinivas Pandit felt quiet and doing pranam to all the books like if they are Jiva Goswami, Rupa Goswami, Sanatana Goswami, Krishna. There is the explanation of Sanatana Goswami, Vaishnava Goswami of Bhagavatam. Jiva Goswami, Lagu Vaishnava Goswami. And all the books of Srila Rupa Goswami, Ujjwal Nilmani Bhakti Goswami, Sindhu. All the books of Krishna Das Kaviraj Goswami. Sandarbha, all the Sarsandarbha were there, Sarsambhadi and all, Gopal Chambu, all. And he became so melted. He told that you have given me life. Then initiated, not only him, his wife, his children, and his all ministers, that's his counselor. And king gave his heart, mind, show and everything to him. I am your eternal servant. And he never disobeyed in his whole life. We see in these days that you have initiated anyone and he will give you everything and next day he will go to another guru, Sahajiya guru or any other guru, Brahmavadi guru, here. And he will, if Guru Deva tells, oh, kindly come to me, I will not come. So, now it is a very big problem and that is why we are not having Krishna prayer. No bhakti, pure bhakti. So we should try to follow. Srinivasacharya. And then he took all the cards and went to Bengal. There to Katwa and then Shyamananda and Narottam Thakur were also called, and so many were called. And in our whole Bengal, even to Assam, and everywhere, Manipur, Bhakti was priest. He was so a scholar. Then he used to explain Srimad Bhagavatam. Waiting. And Krishna, with his all beloved gopis, they used to come and give darshan. And he was a very beautiful kirtaniya. And he has so many rag and ragini, melody. And he used to play on mridangam as if he will quickly jump. Nana, any of also Srimasa. They have some
Ragini,
Manohar Sahi,
and
Garanhati, Manohar Sahi. So many beautiful Ragini. Ragini, you know, that. Oh, good. Sare Gama Padhani Sa, and then Sani Dhapa Magari. Very beautiful. When Krishna used to sing in Pancham, in five. Then Gopi followed and they used to sing in seven. And Krishna had no tune there. And then Krishna used to tell, oh sadhu, 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 I cannot do like you. So his one of the daughter was named Hemlata Thakurani. He became preacher, very famous preacher. He was perhaps married to anyone. And she was very famous preacher. So many disciples they made. And thus he was famous. He was married, Sri Maspani. But even Shyamananda also married. But Narottam Thakur was not married. But all used to give the same respect to three and when they used to mean together, like bosom brother, like what?
Bosom friend.
We should try to follow them and to be devoted like them. If you are falling, only 1% even, it is enough for us. So you should be strong follower of all this. I have come here only to sprinkle their mercies to you. You should not disobey, never doubt anything in bhakti. Only you want to, you should try to give your akhand prem, akhand love. Only to Krishna and devotees, not to anyone. Don't what? To any fraction. Then you will be a pure devotee. Gaur Praman. Today it will be some play. Not today, we are not ready. Then any different? Sorry, you have to announce their name.
Andrew Wainwright, just stand up.
Oh, Abhinandan Das Prabhu.
Yay! His wife, Anamari. Anamari.
It's all there.
Oh, okay.
Abhinandan.
Daniel
Gitt. Abhinandan. Gauranga Sundar. Gauranga Sundar Prabhu ji.
Anybody else have not received the name? Please raise their hand.
Very good. What is that? You can do Gaja Radharam and Haribo. I said you should do, but you should do Gauranga Bali Chahari, then that.
Thank you. Thank you.
आश्चर्य डिवोटी के इंग्रेस लॉ was initiated first by Gaur Gobind Maharaj and then we took second initiation by me and brought the great law upon Mishra Puri.
Jagdish. Saru, Bhakta Saru.
Jagdish. Jagdish. আমার সঙ্গে আসতে বলছিলেন, ওকে দেখেছিলাম কোথাও
সুদর্শন
সচিনন্দন রেড ক্লথ Always like we.
Sometimes
going here. He told that I am coming with you. He is not with us. He knows. He is not with us. I want to धन्यवाद की बुलाए.
Thank you all.
Thank you, the devotees of Bath. And devotees of Bath has no problem. And also they are helping me and helping all the devotees for their problem. I want that the householders everywhere, they should be like them. Yashodanandan and Anand Mohini, how love each other. Both are independent, but though both are cooperative. He has given all kinds of freedom for Anand Manjari. She thinks that, oh, half is mine or fully is his husband and Anand, what? Same like that. I also, Buddha Prabhu, how they are living so peacefully, helping each other and giving each other so much facilities. Our singer
Krishna Kanta
and how beautifully helping each other. No problem, I have heard anything, only problem. How we can have the mercy of my Gurudev? Giving everything to Gurudev. And also Damodar artist
Samapriya and Damodar.
Damodar Prabhu is here.
Yeah.
I thank you all so much. I am so much happy. I want that all should be like
this.
They have nothing to eat, nothing to do, anything, only serving me. I want that devotees should be like Madan Mohan and
Vishakha.
Also, devotees should be like, what name?
Madhav Pandit.
Madhav Pandit and
Madhav Pandit and Nagari.
Nagari. Their jewels. I want that they should be like this. If householders. And if not householders, oh, very good. To be like Raghunath Das Goswami. If you are not householders, yes. Is strong. I want that all the devotees who have crossed 45 and they are not with their wives, they should be like Raghunath Das Goswami. Why they are thinking so much here, there? What are their problems? What are their problems? I don't know. कोनो लोग नहीं खावार वाला, देखो। अपन बाहर जाए चाहे उधर बिकाल देला क्लास में। So don't make your problems. If you are married, all very good. Each other helping, like what I told. We have seen Nirgun Prabhu in also in a stadium. What name? Pripalla and his wife and children. Whole family like this. They have never told me any problem. Only problem how we can serve you and Krishna. There no any requirement, no worldly desire or anything. So I want that those who are householders, they should be like them. Like Srinivas Acharya, Srivas Acharya, Srivas Pandit. Like Srinivas Acharya also, like Shyamananda Prabhu, householders. Why all these things? Only problem should be that. How, where I can have Krishna darshan? Only this, nothing else. And if we are like no world, no wife, no children, nothing, then we try to be like Raghunath Das Goswami. How bona fide, how. What are the teachings of Prahlad Maharaj and what are the teachings of Raghunath Das Goswami? He received from Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Asarup Damodar. Can you compare? Bolo. Bolo. Can you compare? What I told? What is my question?
Which are better?
Compare. A study should be given. Between? Prahlad Maharaj's life and Raghunath Das Goswami, side by side. What is Prahlad Maharaj? This would be renounced like him. That evening, being in house of family person, never wanted anything from Krishna. Never. And always seeing here and there his Ishtadev. And everything, in everything he used to see his Ishtadev. And helping so much to demon boys and all to be a very bona fide devotee. His teachings are like Brahma Gyan. Bhakta also, but nearer to Brahma Gyan. But he was true devotee. Uttam Bhagavat. So, he was Jnani Bhakta, but not Jnani. There is so much difference between Jnani and Jnani Bhakta. Can you tell something? Who is Jnani Bhakta and who is Jnani? Why you sit so much for? I will have to take a danda, you know, stick, bamboo stick, very long.
But Jnani and Jnani Dharma?
Jnani is someone who is trying for impersonal aspect of absolute Brahma. And a Jnani Bhakta is a Bhakta whose Bhakti is mixed with Aishwarya Jnan, that means the knowledge that my Ishudev is God.
The devotees of lotus bath. And devotees of bath has no problem. And also they are helping me and helping all the devotees for their problems. I want that the householders everywhere, they should be like them. Yashodanandan and Anand Mohini, how love each other. Both are independent, but though both are cooperative. He has given all kinds of
happiness.
No.
Problem.
Freedom for Anand Mohini. She thinks that, oh, half his mind or fully is his husband and Anand, what?
Yashodanandan.
Same like that. And also, Buddha Prabhu, how they are living so peacefully, helping each other and giving each other so much facilities. Our singer,
Krishna Kanta
and how beautifully helping each other. No problem, I have heard anything, only problem. How we can have the mercy of my Gurudev? Giving everything to Gurudev. And also artist. Damodar Prabhu is here?
Yes.
I thank you all so much. I am so much happy. I want that all should be like
this.
They have nothing to eat, nothing to do, anything, only serving me. Please. I want that devotees should be like Madan Mohan and
Vishakha.
Also, devotees should be like what name?
Madhav Pandit
and
Nagari.
They are jewels. I want that they should be like this. If householders. And if not householders, oh, very good. To be like Raghunath Das Goswami. If you are not householders, yes. Pramper is home. I want that all the devotees who have crossed 45 and they are not with their wives, they should be like Prabhupada Das Goswami. Why they are thinking so much here, there? What are their problems? What are their problems? কোনো লোক নাই খাবার বালা এখন এখন বাইরে আছে ওটা বিকাল বেলা ক্লাসে বল তো ডোন্ট মেক ইউর প্রবলেম ইফ ইউ আর ম্যারিড অল ভেরি গুড ইচ আদার হেল্পিং লাইক হোয়াট আই টোল্ড দেয়ার শিপ নির্গুণ প্রভু ইন Also in a stadium. What name? Prince Palla and his wife and children. Whole family like this. They have never told me any problem. Only problem how we can serve you and Krishna. They have no any requirement, no worldly desire or anything. So I want that those who are householders, they should be like them. Like Srivas Pandit. Like Srinivas Acharya also. like Shyamananda Prabhu, householder. Why all these things? Only problem should be that. How, where I can have Krishna darshan? Only this, nothing else. And if we are like no work, no wife, no children, nothing, then we try to be like Raghunath Das Goswami. How bonafide, how? What are the teachings of Prahlad Maharaj and what are the teachings of Raghunath Das Goswami? They received from Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Aswarup Damodar. Can you compare? Bolo. Can you compare? What I told? What is my question?
Which are better?
Compare. A compare study should be given. Between Prahlad Maharaj's life and Raghunath Das Goswami, side by side. What is Prahlad Maharaj? This would be pronounced like that evening, being in house of family person, never wanted anything from Krishna, never. And always seeing here and there his Ishtadev. And everything, in everything he used to see his Ishtadev. And helping so much to demon boys and all to be a very bona fide devotee. His teachings are like Brahma Gyan. Bhakta also, but nearer to but he was true devotee, Uttam Bhagavat. So, he was Jnani Bhakta, but not Jnani. But so much difference between Jnani and Jnani Bhakta. Can you tell something? Who is Jnani Bhakta and who is Jnani? Why you sit so much for? I will have to take a danda. Danda, you know? Stick, bamboo stick, very long. What Jnani and Jnani Bhakta?
Jnani is someone who is trying for impersonal aspect of absolute Brahma. And a Jnani Bhakta is a Bhakta whose bhakti is mixed with Aishwarya Jnan. That means the knowledge that my Ishtadev is God.
Belfast. First he told, bolo to, kya kaha?
Jnani is the one who is engaged in, concentrating on impersonal aspects of the Lord. Whereas Jnani is trying to serve Lord.
कहने पर भी नहीं मतलब तुम ध्यान तो इसलिए करते इसमें ध्यान देगा उसमें ध्यान तुम अपना ध्यान ठीक से नहीं What he told? Can you tell? What he told? You should again repeat.
Yes.
What he told?
She was explaining that the Jnani is a person who is cultivating knowledge, the ascending process. Cultivating knowledge with the intention of realizing Brahma, the impersonal feature of the Absolute. Whereas the Gyani Bhakta...
What?
And? Whereas the Gyani Bhakta...
And to have...
Liberation.
Sai Jimukti. He wants to merge himself in impersonal and Gyani Bhakta.
The Gyani Bhakta, he is a pure devotee and he is engaged in devotional service to the Lord. But his mood of love towards the Lord is mixed with knowledge of the opulence of the Lord, knowing that the Supreme Lord is the creator, the controller, the all-powerful, and all types of Bhagavat Tapagyan is there. Therefore, he may remember the Lord, but he may not serve the Lord very intimately, give him food or a glass of water, because he knows my Lord is not thirsty, he is not hungry, or any of these things.
So Prahlad Maharaj is not Jnani, Jnani Bhakta. Name all the tats. Who is Brahma? Who is Jeev? What is Bhakti? Like this. If you will see Krishna, oh, Krishna has so much opulences. He had no birth, no anything like this. So he is Bhakta, much better. And whereas Raghunath Das Goswami, what is? He is Uttam Mahabhagavat, like Prahlad Maharaj. But Uttam Bhagavat are of two kinds. He looking towards affluence of Krishna and everything. And Raghunath Das Goswami, this would be fine. He teaches his life, his all things. How? Don't do whom? Don't do whom?
Raghunath Das Goswami.
He had nothing to do with affluence. He had nothing to do with all these things what Prahlad Maharaj had. But all things which had Prahlad Maharaj, all teachings, all roots were in the Lord's feet, dust of Raghunath Das Goswami. Understand? Everything. He had nothing to do with affluence. He was only, he wanted only to emerge in Braj Prem, Gopi Prem. Antare Karan Nishtha Bahye Lok Vyavahar. But Bhaluna Khaibe, Bhaluna Paribe, Amani Mano Dhaye Krishna Seva, Manushe Paribe. Then अंतरे यद सिद्ध दे करिया भावन रात्रि दिने राधा कृष्णे करेश always he used to be immersed in राधा कृष्ण जुगल service nothing else his bhairagya was for this if he want to be a pure devotee you can follow Prahlad Maharaj, but more follow, try to follow, nearest Raghunath Das Goswami. Bhalo na khaibe, bhalo na paribe. Don't eat delicious and so much rajasic. So much rich food, don't take. Never. Otherwise you cannot control your senses. Bhalo na khaibe, bhalo na paribe. Advire to decorate yourself with good, qualified, highly dresses. And, kikarbe, manushe seva. and do always engage yourself in jugal service, conjugal love and unity. So his Raghunath Das Goswami character and devotion is topmost. But we cannot realize this. So we'll have to first know all these things of Prahlad Maharaj. And as if you have so much any Tattva Rasik Vaishnava of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu line, then you can follow Raghunath Das Goswami. How he used to take remains of Jagannath, but even rejected by house, and he used to take so happily. Why? Why he used to take? What was the reason? What was the reason? He rejected everything. He rejected the prasadam of Jagannath Dev. He rejected the to a stand on Singhadwar, anyone did. And then he rejected all things. His father's giving anything he rejected that his father gave. He wanted to give up. That he used to do bhajan, but I want to help the Brahmin and one servant, always cooking for you, giving very good things, because you are son of a king like me. But he refused. Why? To be a good, bona fide devotee. So he used to take. If he will take anything good, then he will fool his stomach up to him. And though so many problems will come. So he used to take a rotten Jagannath Prasadam. Even rejected by cows, so rotten, he used to wash him with water. And then give him some
salt.
One, two brush. Nothing more. And if it is tasteful, then what he will do? Take it, more. And then he will have to sleep. And then he will have to search anything more. So we should try to learn all these things so that suddenly we can remind Radha Krishna Kanjugal Ghor Nityananda Prabhu. If you want to be devotee, your all requirements will Krishna take on his head and will give it to you. He will be more anxious. If you are not doing anything, only observing in this, then Krishna will take all things that you require on his head and he will bring it to you. You can test it. You should not take anything. One day, 2 days, 3 days, I'm chanting, remembering and serving him. And you see that anyhow Krishna, he is funny. Anyhow he will arrange. If you have no trust, no belief, you can see. But I am looking. I am seeing that he is doing, but you are not. And those who are not like this, Krishna will be very far away from. So, you should try to be like this. Bhalo na khaive, bhalo na parive, amami manavda hai, Krishna seva, manasya. Sadalave. Vraja Radha Krishna seva, manasya kare. And more, when it was told to Raghunath Das Goswami, when he was first, Bhalona khaive wala. Don't be batul.
Pare phire jao rukhu naho batul. Kame kame paye log bhava sundhu kul.
He told first time. It was told in Shantipur. Shantipur?
Advaita Acharya.
Shantipur. When he met Chaitanya. At that time he was not married. But always met for meeting Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu told him that don't be met. At once return to home. And many one should not see your Krishna this move. Don't do Markat Bairagya. Markat Bairagya means?
Renounce like monkeys.
Monkeys. No marriage, but all married. Always his sight.
Enjoy.
If you go to Vrindavan with so many bananas and sweets and everything, they will take it very easily. Like that, oh, and they will take it. And you will be like, they will take everyone. So they are renounced like monkeys. Don't be like that. I have seen so many. But you should also be always enjoying and doing so. Marka bhairagya na kar roke dikhaiya jatai yogya visham hoja anasaktaiya. What is helpful, what is favorable for Krishna bhakti, you should take only that thing, not more. Don't try to collect anything. Whether greedy, whether householder or
renounced.
And always remember Krishna. Don't give your energy to anything else here. And then you should advance your
Krishna.
Antekaranishta, loke vyavahar, by loke vyavahar. Means? You should. What is the meaning? Antekaranishta, bahya loke vyavahar.
Internally, one should be established in his relationship with Krishna. And externally, one should follow the behavior.
Don't show your bhakti, devotion. Your devotion, you should keep it in your heart. Antare nishtha. Nishtha to Ishtadev, Radha Krishna Kanjugal, Mahaprabhu, Nityananda. And bahya, outwardly, you should have, oh, you are okay? How are you? How are your children? My affection to your children. No harm, telling. So bahya lok vyavahar. But don't have any start to bahya. That we are doing. Getting so many things and having so much affection for them. And nishtha only outside, not internally. And lok vyavahar where? Oh, internally, for Krishna. Oh, you should take this, you should take this. Sometimes going to devote Nagar Sankirtan and doing like Hare Krishna, like monkeys dancing. No nishtha, nishtha is outside. And what we should be internally, it becomes how? Opposite things. So we should try to do it. I want that all whose wives have kicked them or their wives have died, oh, they should be like, no. No anxiety, no
problems.
Prabhu, your household, your wife is with you? You're Italian.
Me?
Yeah.
No,
I am not
married. Bachelor.
Oh, you are how lucky and fortunate. I think that you have no problem at all. No problem?
No kind of problem.
His problem was he wanted to go to India, but I am not allowed to go to India.
There are so many problems I know. I want that, there should be no only problem. Oh, Krishna, like this. Then you will be. Oh, very strong. I want that all should be like that. So all the bhakta yogriyas,
household devotees,
they should be like Srivasacharya, Srinivasacharya, Srivas Pandit, like others. Raghav Pandit, like this. And renounced orders should be like that. Those who are brahmachari, they should not desire to eat very big laddu. Laddu, you know? Don't have greed to take laddu. Oh, very dangerous, poisonous. And thus try to engage yourself in Krishna consciousness. All is God. Gaur Prema.
Hari Om.
Guru Dev, Guru Dev, Guru Dev, Guru Dev, Guru Dev, Guru Dev.